गुड मॉर्निंग फ्रेंड्स, इन लास्ट लेक्चर वी स्टार्टेड विद जनरल फार्माकोलॉजी सेक्शन. अंडर जनरल फार्माकोलॉजी सेक्शन वी कंप्लीटेड फर्स्ट चैप्टर, दैट इज इंट्रोडक्शन टू फार्माकोलॉजी. नाउ फ्रॉम टुडे वी स्टार्ट विद द सेकंड चैप्टर अंडर जनरल फार्माकोलॉजी, दैट इज रूट्स ऑफ एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन ऑफ ड्रग्स. की जे मार्केटमध्ये ड्रग्स आहेत ते ड्रग आपल्या बॉडीमध्ये कुठल्या कुठल्या रूटने, कुठल्या कुठल्या चॅनलने एंटर होतात, अँड व्हॉट आर द ॲडव्हान्टेजेस अँड डिसअडव्हान्टेजेस ऑफ डिफरंट रूट्स ऑफ ॲडमिनिस्ट्रेशन. यू नो दॅट इन टुडेज प्रॅक्टिस ऑफ मेडिसिन्स ड्रग्स आर अवेलेबल इन व्हेरियस डोसेज फॉर्म्स. लाईक सम ड्रग्स अवेलेबल इन सॉलिड डोसेज फॉर्म, सम इन लिक्विड डोसेज फॉर्म, सम सेमी सॉलिड डोसेज फॉर्म, then biphasic liquid, injectable preparations. These are the various dosage forms available in market. In order to administer all these different dosage forms, various routes of administrations are going to be available. Some drugs given by oral route, some drug given by injectables, while some drug applied topically or locally to produce the effect. By any route, when drug given produces either of these two effects, कुठल्याही रूटने तुम्ही ड्रग घ्या, इट प्रोड्युसेस आयदर ऑफ दिस टू इफेक्ट. वन दॅट मे प्रोड्युसेस सिस्टेमिक इफेक्ट ऑर इन सम केसेस मे प्रोड्युसेस लोकल इफेक्ट. नाउ व्हॉट इज सिस्टेमिक इफेक्ट? इट इज द इफेक्ट प्रोड्यूस बाय द ड्रग आफ्टर कंप्लीट ऍब्सॉर्प्शन इन टू ब्लड स्ट्रीम. की जेव्हा तुम्ही कुठल्याही रूटने जेव्हा ड्रग घेणार, वेन ड्रग एंटर इन टू द ब्लड ऑर इन सिस्टेमिक सर्क्युलेशन अँड प्रोड्युसेस द इफेक्ट, that phenomenon, that effect, that is called a systemic effect. That is the effect produced by the drug after complete absorption into bloodstream or enter into systemic circulation. That phenomenon, that effect is called a systemic effect. Why? Second effect, that is local effect. Local effect, that is the effect produced by the drug in localized area where it is applied. Topically or externally when it is applied, it produces effect. That effect, that is called as local. So by any route you administer the drug, produce an either systemic effect or local effect. Now these routes of administration of the drugs classified broadly into three types. Majorly there are three types of routes of administration of the drug. One, suppose this is the classification of routes of administration. First type, that is called as enteral route of administration. Second, that is called as parenteral route of administration. And third, that is called as local or topical route of administration. Majorly, there are three types of routes of administration. One, that is called as enteral route. Second, parenteral route. And third one is local or topical route of administration. These are the three major routes. Now let us see first, that is enteral route of administration. This word enteral derived from Greek word, that is enteron. Enteron means intestine. Remember that this word is derived from Greek word, that is enteron. Enteron means intestine. Means those drug passes through GIT, passes through intestine and reaches into blood, then that route of administration is called as enteral route of administration. Means passes through intestine or passes through GIT and then enter into the blood. Therefore, this route of administration is called as enteral route. Now again, this enteral route divided into three types. First, this is oral route of administration. Second, subliminal route of administration. And third, that is called as rectal route of administration. Under enteral, again divided into three types, oral, sublingual and rectal. Now another type, major type, that is parenteral. Again, this word is derived from Greek word, that is para. Para means beyond and enteral means intestine, beyond the intestine. Parenteral route of administration where drugs administered beyond intestine, beyond GIT tract, directly drug enter into the blood or enter into systemic circulation without bypass to GIT, and therefore that route of administration is called a parenteral route of administration. This parenteral route again divided into four. four types. One, that is called as injections. Second, inhalation. Third, hydrophoresis. And fourth one is inoction. Parenteral route again divided into four types. One, that is injection. Second, inhalation. Third, hydrophoresis. And fourth one is inoction. Now, injections again divided into different types. There are variety of injections. Some drugs, some injectable preparations given by intradermal route of administration, that is intradermal. Some injectable preparations given by subcutaneous route of administration. Another type, that is intramuscular route of administration. Another one, intravenous. Then intrathecal route of administration. Intramedullary. Intraparatoneal route of administration. These are the variety of route of administration. That is under injection, intradermal, subcutaneous, intramuscular, intravenous, another route, intrathecal route of administration, intramedullary, intraparatoneal, then intracardiac, that is another route, intracardiac. These are the types under the injections. Then second one, inhalation, some drug given by inhalation, direct enter into the blood. Third one is hydrophoresis, and fourth one is inaction. And last, third type, that is local or topical, where drugs applied locally or topically in the form of creams, paste, jellies, ointment. These route of administration, that is called a local or topical route of administration. So this is the first question. Generally in annual examination, there may be questions that classify routes of administration. So you are supposed to write that there are majorly three types. These are the three types. Then what is enteral route? Then different types of enteral route. What is parenteral route? Different types of parenteral route. And third one is local or topical. Even in this chapter, we see the various advantages and disadvantages of various routes of administration. You know that enteral, that this word is derived from Greek word, that is enteron. Enteron means intestine. Those drug passes through GIT, passes through intestine, that route of administration, that is called as enteral route of administration. Under enteral, first type, that is oral route of administration. Now, oral route, this is the most commonest route of administration. Generally, apan sagle jan lahan mulapasun tar mataranpareunt sagle jan drug administration karnyasathi jo route apan prefer karto, that is called as oral route. Therefore, called as oral route, that is the most commonest route of administration. Generally, drugs in the form of tablets, that is solid dosage form or liquid dosage forms, given along with the water or along with the milk and passes through mouth cavity, that route of administration, that is called as oral route. Generally, the drugs in the form of solid, maybe tablet, maybe capsules, or liquid dosage form, generally given along with the water or along with the milk. And in this route, some tablets given by chewable, that is chewable tablets also available in market, that is also given by oral route of administration. Now, what are the advantages? Why oral route is called as common route of administration? Most of the time in annual examination, there may be questions which is the most commonest route of administration and why. No doubt, these are the different routes of administration available, but out of this, the commonest route of administration, that is oral route of administration. Now, why it is commonest? There are certain advantages. Advantages, that is also called as the merits. Merits or advantages. Now, what are the advantages of oral route of administration? You know that oral route, that is the most convenient, economical route of administration. It is cheap. And another one, that it is most acceptable route of administration. Sagalyana avadnara route of administration. Lahan mulanna sudha tumhi tablet deu shakta, mothyanna deu shakta. Acceptable route. That is, the what are the different advantages? First time, it is very convenient, economical route of administration, chief, most acceptable route of administration. Even another advantage, that self-medication of the drug is possible by this route of administration. Oral route mein tumhi swatahun swatah medicament ghu shakta. Dusre ki garaj padat. For example, in injectable. Injectable, there is a skilled person is going to require. While in case of oral route, self-medication of the drug, patient swatahun मेडिकामेंट स्वतः घे शको दैट इज सेल्फ मेडिकेशन ऑफ द ड्रग इज पॉसिबल. अनदर एडवांटेज ऑफ दिस रूट ऑफ एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन दैट दिस ओरल रूट वेयर देयर इज नो स्किल नो प्रॉपर टेक्निक इज गोइंग टू बी रिक्वायर्ड. व्हाई इन केस ऑफ इंजेक्टेबल प्रॉपर स्किल और टेक्निक इज गोइंग टू बी रिक्वायर्ड फॉर एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन. हियर जस्ट यू टेक स्वालो द टैबलेट अलोंग विद द वाटर और मिल्क दैट इज देयर इज नो स्किल रिक्वायर्ड फॉर एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन ऑफ द ड्रग. अनदर एडवांटेज दैट ड्यूरिंग मैन्युफैक्चरिंग और ड्यूरिंग एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन ऑफ द ड्रग there is no sterilization technique required during manufacturing or during administration. Why? Here in case of injectable aseptic conditions are not required. Here there is no need during administration even during manufacturing. Just to follow the GMP and prepare to manufacture the drug and even administer the drug. But why? In case of parenteral there is strict aseptic conditions. Sterile conditions are not required. But here there is no strict aseptic or conditions required during administration or during manufacturing. So these are the different advantages of oral route. And due to these advantages, oral route that is the most commonest route of administration. This question repeated in different annual examinations. So just remember that which is the most commonest route. Why it is commonest? Because of these advantages. So oral route that is the most commonest route. Advantages or merits, these are the advantages or merits. Now what are the demerits or disadvantages of oral route? First disadvantage of oral route of administration that whatever the drug given by oral route, it shows slow onset of action, and therefore this route is not useful in emergency patients. ki ekada patient la attack hoto hai anjana pe koi sa tras hota hai तुम्ही ओरल रूट में द्रव घेऊ शकत नाही. हियर दिस इज बिकॉज बाय ओरल रूट ऑफ एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन देयर इज अ स्लो ऑनसेट ऑफ एक्शन एंड देयरफॉर नो इफेक्टिव इन इमरजेंसी कंडीशंस. अनदर डिसएडवांटेज और डीमेरिट ऑफ ओरल रूट ऑफ एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन दैट इरिटेंट एंड अनपैलेटेबल ड्रग इज एच टेस्ट एकदम इरिटेबल आहे अनपैलेटेबल आहे सच अ ड्रग ऑल्सो शुड नॉट बी गिवन बाय ओरल रूट ऑफ एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन. Another disadvantage that those drug destroyed in GID that is in gastrointestinal tract due to GID pH or those drug having first pass metabolism that those drug after administration reaches at the site of liver such a drug should not be given by oral route of administration. If the drug GID mane gastrointestinal tract mein destroyed hote inactivate hote or those drug having first pass metabolism also should not be given by oral route of administration. Another disadvantage that if patients suffering from vomiting and diarrhea condition ki ekada patient la continue vomiting and diarrhea hai and if you give the drug by oral route may not be effective because of vomiting and diarrhea condition. Another disadvantage that if the patient become unconscious beshuddha self and uncooperative self in that condition also this route is not effective, isn't it? So these are the different disadvantages or demerits of oral route. These are the different advantages of oral route, and due to these advantages oral route that is the most commonest route of administration. So generally here there are two questions. First question that which is the most commonest route of administration and why, then just write down advantages. If they ask question mention advantages and disadvantages of oral route, then you supposed to write down advantages and then write down disadvantages, isn't it? So this is the first route under enteral route, that is oral route of administration. Then we go for second route, that is sublingual route of administration. Now here you remember that this word sublingual, sub means below. Sub means below and lingual means below the tongue, where the drugs or medicaments, the tablet containing medicament placed below the tongue, jibhe khali the tablet lagata tha, and drug dissolve in mouth cavity and then through buccal mucosa absorbed into the blood or enter into systemic circulation. Therefore that route of administration called as sublingual route of administration. Most of the time when we ask question that what is sublingual route, mention advantages and disadvantages. Sub means below. Below the tongue. Where the drugs kept below the tongue. Jeeve khali tablet honi jate. And drug dissolve in mouth cavity and then enter into the blood or then enter into systemic circulation. Therefore, that route of administration is called as sublingual route of administration. Generally, you know that in angina pectoris, the tablet like nitroglycerin tablet, which has a patient has heart attack, the chances are that in that patient, nitroglycerin tablet or glycerin trinitrate tablet generally given by sublingual route of administration. Even another example, methyl testosterone tablet, nitroglycerin or glycerin nitro tablet, these drugs generally given by sublingual route of administration. Now, what are the advantages or merits of sublingual route? First advantage that whatever the drug given by sublingual route of administration shows fast onset of action as compared to oral route. Here you remember that here comparison that is along with oral route. So as compared to oral route, it shows fast action. And therefore, fast onset of action, this route is useful in emergency condition. For example, in angina pectoris. Angina pectoris means that our nitroglycerin tablet, jeeve khali sorbitrate tablet, patient la dete. Where drug dissolve in mouth cavity and then absorb into the blood. So this route is effective in emergency patients such as angina pectoris due to what? Due to fast onset of action as compared to oral route of administration. Another advantage that those drug having first pass metabolism, ये drug दिलानंतर orally दिलानंतर directly reaches at the site of liver, like nitroglycerin tablet. Nitroglycerin tablet should not be given orally because if given orally it reaches directly at the site of liver and destruction occurs in activation there. To avoid this, it should be given by sublingual route of administration. Means those drug having first pass metabolism. Such a drug given by sublingual route of administration. Even those drugs destroyed by GID or in gastrointestinal tract pH, such a drug also given by sublingual route of administration. These are the advantages or merits of sublingual route. Why, what are the disadvantages of this route? That first disadvantage that those drugs having direct toxic effect at the site of heart should not be given by sublingual route of administration. If that drug has direct heartburn effect, toxic effect, such a drug should not be given by sublingual route of administration. Even another disadvantage that irritant and unpalatable taste. If that drug taste of the irritant or unpalatable, such a drug also should not be given by this route of administration. Another disadvantage that high molecular weight substances also should not be given by this route of administration. So remember that these are the advantages and these are the disadvantages of sublingual route. Sometimes instead of asking oral route, they may ask mention merits and demerits or advantages and disadvantages of sublingual route. Or what is sublingual route? Name the drug administered by sublingual route. Mention advantages and disadvantages. So this is second route of administration under enteral route of administration, that is called as sublingual route of administration. Now the last third under enteral route, that is called as rectal route of administration. Rectal route where drugs in the form of liquid medicaments given through the rectum. In rectal route of administration where drugs in the form of liquid medicaments given through rectum. Rectum reach in its venous blood supply. So those drugs destroyed in GID, those drugs should not be given by oral route. Such a drug generally given by rectal route of administration. In case of rectal, depending on the drug, drug may produce either systemic effect or local effect. So generally, the drugs like enema preparations, you know that enema preparation that is useful in constipations. Even certain suppositories are also available in the market given by rectal route of administration. So generally the preparation given by rectal route, that is enema preparations and suppository. Now here enema preparation, these are the liquid medicaments given through the rectum. There are two types of enema preparations. One that is called as evacuate enema and second one that is called as retention enema. There are two type of enema preparations. One that is called as evacuate enema and second one that is called as retention enema. Now evacuate enema means these type of enema used to remove fecal matter from intestine. Intestine matter, fecal matter condition that is useful in constipation. And the maximum quantity of liquid given through evacuate enema that is not more than 600 ml. For example, soap water enema available in market. Maximum quantity of fluid given by this evacuate enema route that is up to 600 ml. Where in this enema, that is where soap water enema given, soap causes lubrication of pathway. Soap causes lubrication of pathway while water causes distortion of stomach. ये वॉल्यूम वाइडला हमारे काम आ रहे डिस्टॉर्शन होना रहे एंड बिकॉज ऑफ डिस्टॉर्शन ऑफ स्टमक एंड लुब्रिकेशन ऑफ पथवे इजीली रिमूवल ऑफ फिकल मैटर टेक प्लेस फ्रॉम इंटेस्टाइन एंड दैट टाइप ऑफ एनेमा दैट इज कॉल्ड एज इवैक्यूएट एनेमा. जनरली दीज एनेमा यूजफुल ड्यूरिंग एब्डोमिनल सर्जरी ड्यूरिंग गैस्ट्रोस्कोपी ड्यूरिंग सर्जिकल ऑपरेशन दीज टाइप ऑफ एनेमा प्रिपरेशन गिवन टू द पेशेंट इन ऑर्डर टू रिमूव द फिकल मैटर. सो दैट टाइप ऑफ एनेमा that is called as evacuate enema. Second type that is retention enema, where drugs retain at the site of rectum, drug or medicament that is retained at the site of rectum and slowly drug absorbed and then produces pharmacological action. For example, prednisolone enema, this prednisolone enema available in market, even for basal anesthesia medicaments given by rectal route of administration. And the maximum quantity of liquid administered in case of retention enema that is not more than 120 ml. Just the 120 ml from the retention enema medication. Where drugs or the liquid medicament that containing the drug retain at the site of rectum and thereby produces long action. Sometimes may produce a systemic effect or depending on the category of the drug may produce a local effect. Drug retained at the site of rectum and produces long sustained action. Example, prednisolone enema used in ulcerative colitis, and another example that is basal anesthesia, where these type of enema preparations are given to the patient and the maximum quantity of fluid that is should not be more than 120 ml. So that type of enema that is retention enema. So this is the third type that is rectal. So today we completed first type of route of administration that is enteral, oral, sublingual and rectal. In next lecture we see regarding parenteral route of administration. So thank you and go for more subscribers.